In this video, we're gonna be comparing a smartphone gimbal versus the latest GoPro. We're gonna do some really cool stabilization side-by-side comparisons, and then I'll cover the pros and cons of each so you can figure out which one might be the best fit for you. Now for the ultimate stabilization test. We're gonna do with and without gimbal, action mode, on and off, Joby, GoPro 11. Let's do some side-by-sides and see which one comes out on top. First up, iPhone 14 Pro handheld with and without action mode on the ultra wide. Popping into action mode, you will see that it crops in on the ultra wide a fair bit. Next, for a little $40-ish iPhone setup, I think this will add a little bit of stability, action mode on and off. Let's go. Then for the ultimate test, gimbal versus GoPro. Which one you guys think is gonna win? Place your bets below. Now filming on the GoPro, we're gonna have the highest resolution at 5.3K and the widest field of view. Is it gonna be the best stabilization though? All right, this is linear horizon lock. So it's like having a digital gimbal. Now for the gimbal, we're tracking on Dalton here and action. So as you just saw, I think I'd give the better stabilization to the GoPro, at least in those tests. Plus, if you punch out even wider to hyper view on the GoPro, it's crazy wide angle and rock steady stabilization, which is very impressive. Now let's cover the pros and cons of each, starting with the GoPro. Of course, it's small, it's durable, easily mountable, it's waterproof. I mean, it's meant for the action shots, and that resolution at 5.3K is probably gonna look the sharpest and widest field of view. Now for some of the cons. The battery life just kind of stinks. The price is dang expensive, $450 on Amazon right now. And then of course, since it's not a gimbal, that app has a lot of the limited functionality. You don't have that motion control and tracking and all that fun stuff. Now for some pros and cons on the Insta360 Flow, the gimbal that we've been using. Their app is just top of the line. There's a ton of cool, unique features under the hood. There's some really cool motion controlled time-lapse modes built right into the app. Are we switch to the ultra wide time lapse mode. Check it out. We're able to set up to 4 points, I believe, on here. So let's go ahead and start it over to the all the way left and up a bit. Hit plus to add a point. Slide all the way over. Hit plus. I think that's good enough for now, but you could do more if you wanted. If we record for 4 minutes, it's going to give us a 16 second clip. Hit go. Automatically moves to point A.
Dang, that looks sick.
For playback, check this out. You can just scroll this little wheel back and forth and it'll smooth playback, scrub that timeline. Just quick press the power button down here and it'll get you back right into your shooting mode. Now in the app, there's a really cool tracking mode. We can either like drag around our subject or just single click the trigger and it's gonna automatically track Dalton here. Let me hit record. It does a pretty decent job. Now this is pre-release firmware and software and you can see it's following him around. But we also found that maybe really fast action movement, it sort of loses the track.
Oh, yep, that was it. It lost you.
I don't know if that's gonna get, you know, maybe a little bit better with testing. Oh, look at that. It picked back up on you. That's pretty cool. Now for some advanced tracking testing. We got Dalton here. Let's go ahead and drag a square around him, hit record. Oh. Okay, it kept on to you on the ultra wide. I think they said the ultra wide is better for tracking. Now let's switch over to the 1X. Hey, it stayed on you. All right, now if it can follow you on the 3X, I'll be really impressed. Nope. Yeah, it lost him on the 3X. There's some really cool panorama features in here. We've got 180, 3x3, full spherical. Let's do a quick sample test, show you how easy that is. We got the extendable selfie stick and tripod legs built right into the gimbal. Let's hit go, gives us a countdown.
Kind of like doing those 360 photos just automatically for you.
Boom, check that out. Hey, that looks really good for dynamic range. It's definitely doing some HDR there.
We can see up into the dark rafters and then out those bright skies. The stitching looks pretty good. Check it out, it even kind of removed the tripod. That's cool. Also cool is in the app, we can animate it around. So if you want to quick share that to your socials, there's a few pre-built filters on here and animation styles and stuff like that. Now, even though it's not as pocketable as a GoPro, I mean, in stretchy pants, it actually fits in the pocket or in your backpack. I really like this quick get up and go time. Look, you just snap on your phone, pop this up, boom, power's on the gimbal, and you're ready to rock. So that's really cool. And another really cool feature is that with a little USB cable, you can plug it in here or whatever, plug it into your phone, and then it acts as a little portable battery bank on the go. So that's neat. Now onto maybe a few wishlist items I found. I do love all the power and potential under the hood, but also adds to some of that confusion with the gimbal. This button, this trackpad, there's buttons, joystick, swipe. There's almost too many gestures sometimes where I'm just trying to rotate the gimbal around and I'm forgetting, well, do I double press this one or triple click that one? And it gets a little confusing sometimes. So if you got a modern phone and you're just gonna be filming with it every once in a while, then all the pre-built in stabilization and all that might be good enough for you. If you wanna step it up as maybe shooting real estate or content creation, things like that, a gimbal like this one is a great way to kinda step up your video creation game and get those more cinematic shots. It looks great. If you're looking to get the flow, links down below, and here's what the unboxing looks like.
In the box includes some papers, USB cables, the gimbal, magnetic clamp, snap-on LED, and a plastic see-through carrying pouch.
Huge thanks to Insta360 for sending over the flow. No, this video is not sponsored. And then if you're gonna be needing any sort of stabilized action shots, well, the latest GoPro 11 might be your best bet. It's good resolution, sharp, it's small, compact, durable, waterproof. It's a pretty penny, but it'll get you some pretty cool shots. Now, all links to everything down below. And if you wanna check out my other action camera videos, check those out next. And I'll see subscribers in my next video.